are represented by the Fool and the Three of Swords. So there's something new in the mix for you. Maybe it centers around children or perhaps travel or dealing with people at a distance. But this could be someone new that you're meeting or having involvement with. It's a new experience, and perhaps you weren't prepared to deal with that experience because you have the Three of Swords. So there's some frustration taking place. Maybe there you were trying to move in a new direction. Maybe you changed your residence, or you changed to a new relationship, or you're meeting new people. But there could have been some unexpected and significant changes that occurred for you domestically or career-wise, and you may be heartbroken about those changes. It could be that something unexpected occurred. Maybe there's a third party. Maybe you found yourself making decisions about a love triangle, or maybe there was some interference in your relationship. So you probably received some bad news, or there was an outcome you weren't expecting and you had trouble dealing with that. If you had a sense perhaps that it was on the way, you may be able to, you know, deal with what is and come up with a new plan and move on. But for others of you, especially if you had a hard time dealing with the truth of a situation, you may be struggling to move on. There could have been issues where somebody was uncommitted. Maybe this person just wanted to have a good time, or they wanted to see how the relationship went. They didn't want to have a solid connection. So there's some frustration. It could be even that there's a new situation where you're not even communicating. You're no longer speaking, or you were trying to negotiate something with your partner or a suitor or somebody you were interested in, and it just didn't work out. And it may have to do with the past, some kind of history. Now, some of you, it may be that you or your partner, you come from a family dynasty. Maybe there's a great deal of wealth or power or influence. This may center around some kind of family tradition, or again, your history, the past. For some of you, there's a focus on perhaps property or historical wealth, an inheritance, an investment, your assets, royalties. Or, you know, maybe somebody didn't want to commit. They wanted to stay within their own perceived elevated social status or circle, you know, when dating. And, you know, you're frustrated. You wanted to enjoy yourself. Maybe you wanted to take a time out. Maybe you need to relax, let loose a little bit. And so you were making a decision. Maybe it's centered around travel, but there's some kind of frustration connected to your property or the influence of money or tradition that's interfering with that. Now, the romance is characterized by the Knight of Coins and the Six of Cups. So for some of you, an earth sign person is important. This could be Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female. Or just the traits of the night are important. This may be somebody from your past. It could be a friend. It could be an old love, a lost love, an ex. And there are issues tied to your romance that have to do with faithfulness, loyalty, devotion. And so those could be an issue. Maybe somebody's involved in a secret love affair, or perhaps you were trying to make some progress emotionally and somebody wasn't paying attention. Something was being offered, but perhaps somebody was so self-absorbed or so intent on their own needs and desires that there wasn't anything reciprocated. Now, the Knight of Coins is someone normally who's very dependable, he's reliable, he's looking for a long-term relationship. And again, you have the Fool card, where perhaps one of you doesn't really want a commitment, or one of you was very enthusiastic about something, the relationship or some plans you had in the works, and the other of you was sort of putting a damper on that. You were putting the skids on it. Or somebody is slow to react or respond to an offering of some sort. You're looking to get involved in some kind of social situation that opens up opportunities for you romantically or socially. And if you do decide to get involved with somebody, you don't want the uncommitted. You want something that's stable, reliable, something that's for the long term. You don't want to have a relationship in the moment, or this is vice versa. So, you know, somebody is not reacting. Maybe they're not even talking. They're not providing conversation. Maybe somebody's very traditional. And so there are some issues. Now, you do have an opportunity to work out some details. If you haven't been able to come to a consensus on something, this will give you the patience to work out those details, to come to some kind of conclusion about your economic or your emotional growth or your security. You're looking at past behaviors and patterns, things that you probably have taken for granted up to this point, but you realize that they're having an impact. So maybe you've been spending too much or spending too little, whatever it is that provides security. It could be money, it could be your emotions, it could be your time. Now, the Six of Cups says there's a strong tie to the past that's influencing your present situation. In fact, you may feel like you're having a repeat performance of sorts. There could be some deja vu. Maybe you feel some strong intuition as if you've experienced something before. Now, it could be that you do make some progress. Maybe some avenues and opportunities that you thought were closed suddenly open up. But for others of you, something has, you know, is causing some kind of frustration or grief because there's been a past indiscretion or an oversight that's coming back to roost. So you may be hearing from somebody. This may be welcome. You may be glad. You have opportunity to express yourself. But in other cases, perhaps that's ignored, or you're having to deal with somebody that you really don't want to connect to. And this may tie to your belief system and the recognition of that. It could be you're connected to someone very spiritual. So maybe you're sharing this deep spiritual connection with another person. You have the same core values. But one of you may be more focused on developing your spiritual life as opposed to being in a relationship. Or for some of you, you're just in this connection to learn a spiritual lesson, and that's all. For others of you, your relationship is going to bring about some spiritual evolution for both of you through some lessons. But this is about your belief and your faith in a situation. And also recognizing not just the outer beauty of a person, but also the inner beauty as well. Now, maybe you're working to take care of yourself. For some of you, maybe you're buying a gift for someone. And maybe this is something of beauty, some kind of exchange, or perhaps you are taking some time out from a relationship to take care of yourself, depending on what the circumstances are. If you're dealing with some kind of frustration or somebody doesn't want to commit, you may decide that you're going to focus on yourself, the faith you have in yourself, and you're making some progress to take care of you. Now, why is this occurring?